Hi, my name is Margaret. I live in Mobile, Alabama. I am a gastric sleeve patient of Dr. Almanza's. I had my surgery on Thursday, March 27th of 2014. And I just kind of want to go through my whole start to this point experience of what I haven't already put in my videos, okay? If you check my YouTube subscription, there is, or my YouTube account, there is quite a few videos that I have posted from the very start all the way through now, okay? So let me start here. My start weight was 367 pounds. I booked the surgery because a very good friend of mine, that I've known for many, many years had the sleeve done back in October. And has had phenomenal results, looks amazing, and I want the same results he's had. I'm tired of being overweight, I'm tired of being miserable, and it's time that I did something about it. So with that being said, I want to kind of start here. When I booked my surgery, I did it for several reasons. For one, I was not scared to go to Mexico. For two, I had done a lot of research about the surgeon, about the hospital, about the hotel, about the entire process of the surgery. I could actually probably perform it. I watched the surgery being done so many times on so many YouTube videos. I would not suggest handing me a scalpel and telling me to do it, but I probably could if I needed to. With that being said, a lot of people were very skeptical of me going to Mexico for surgery when they found out, and I was okay with that. I expected it, but I wasn't going to let it stop me. I did go by myself. Now, my surgery was scheduled for the 28th. I had surgery on the 27th, and I'll explain that in a minute. But I booked my flight, paid for my surgery. I got down there on the 27th. Where my airline let me off was a long walk from there to Zone F, which is where they pick you up at. And I was very, very tired by the time I got there. And tiredness is going to hit you like a ton of bricks after this surgery, just an FYI, okay? So please excuse my yawning. But when I got there, the white cargo van, passenger van, pulled up, and there were a couple other people that were being picked up the same time I was on the 27th. And when I went to get in, I fell out of the van. I scared about 50 million people at that airport that day, but I am perfectly fine. No scrapes, no broken bones, no bloody anythings. I'm perfectly good to go. Okay, falling is natural to me. It just happens. Okay, I will say there is nothing to hold on to in that passenger van when you're getting in. So if you have a hard time climbing in, I would definitely recommend seeing if you can ride up front. They let me after I fell. That was very embarrassing, but it was okay. So when we got in the van, we were taken across the border to the lab. The lab is the first place we went. They did our blood work and our EKG. There was a little bit of a situation at the lab where the EKG technician, he's, I would say, probably in his 30s. Very, very, very sexy man, and he knows he's a very sexy man. Made some inappropriate comments about, you know, are you married? Wearing very, very tight jeans, rubbing his junk all up on you. Not really all up on you, but just too close for comfort. Jared from Weight Loss Agents was there with us. He was picked up the same time we were. And we let Jared know about about this situation. And I will get into that in a minute. EKG and blood work didn't take 5 minutes. By the time everybody had been done, we weren't there 20 minutes. We left the lab, and I was asked if I wanted to go ahead and do my surgery that day. And I've been ready for the surgery since the day I booked it. So, of course, I told them, go ahead. Why not? By all means, let's do it. So, we did. They took us to the hospital and got us prepped and ready for surgery. And that afternoon, they wheeled us on back and took us in for surgery. The pre-op part, it's a little different than here in the States. I'm not going to lie. They hook you up to an IV. Your IV is not your anesthesia. It's just fluids and an antibiotic. It's in like a square, almost like a milk carton type container, but it still hangs. Weirdest IV bag I've ever seen. And they wrap your feet and legs in like ACE bandages instead of compression socks. But from what I've heard, that's what they use for compression socks. And nobody I've talked to has had any blood clotting issues. Now, they did go ahead and take us back to the operating room one at a time. You actually walk. You don't ride in a wheelchair or on a gurney to the operating room. You go down this little hall at the hospital. You get on an elevator. You go downstairs. They put you on a gurney down there. And the anesthesiologist is going to look at you and go, are you ready? When you say yes, it's lights out. You won't remember anything else once you say yes. They do your surgery. According to all my tests, I still have both kidneys, so we're still good there. And then, very, very quickly after surgery, you wake up. That was the easiest anesthesia I've ever been under to wake up. I wasn't nauseated. I wasn't, I didn't feel like I was having a heart attack. I mean, it was just like I woke up from a nap. And I love it. I wish the States would use whatever they knocked me out with, because I need some of that. Seriously, it was the best anesthesia I've ever had. Immediately after I woke up, I felt my gas. I was very gassy. They did. My mouth was very dry, though, and I asked them for a bottle of water, which they then told me I could not drink, but I could swish in my mouth. They obviously don't know me well enough, though, to know that good luck telling me don't drink something when you hand it to me, because I'm going to drink it. And I did. Just not a whole lot, but I did swallow that water. It was in a bottle, not out of a faucet. And so, needless to say, about an hour after my surgery, I was up and walking. 2 hours after my surgery, you will see a video in my account that was a testimonial I did for weight loss agents and Dr. Almanza. Dr. Almanza was standing right beside me, and Jared with weight loss agents was right there. They just happened to catch me in the hallway of the hospital walking, joking around about coming back just to drink with them. It was a very pleasant experience that I had. They were very friendly, very, very, very nice people. And I don't regret making a testimonial at all. I look like hell, but it was well worth it for me. So I continued to walk, because according to my friend, the more you walk, the better your pain is. Like, you don't have as much pain. And for me, my pain was very minimal. No worse than menstrual cramps, and to me, that's saying a lot. I really expected a lot more pain than what I had with this surgery. So let's fast forward. I make it through the night, and the next morning they pick us up, take us to the hotel. Hotel was awesome. Very, very nice, nicer than a lot of the hotels here in the US. I did get a private room to stay by myself, which the exchange rate on pesos to dollars actually made the room cheaper than $60 a night. I only ended up paying $153 for 3 nights, which was not bad. I always like saving money. So I get the private room, I get checked in, and then I decide that I want to go shopping. This is the day after surgery, not even 24 hours, but I was ready to get up and go shopping. And I did. I walked and I walked and I walked and I bought and I bought and I bought. And I would come back to the hotel, relax for an hour or so, and then I would go out again. Like I said earlier, this surgery is very, very tiring. You lose all your energy. You do get tired very quickly, and a lot of walking will make you need a nap. But so they came in that night, put an IV in me for about 3.5, maybe 4 hours, just some more fluids and antibiotics. They did tell me that the doctor was coming in and to take a shower, to take my bandages off. When the doctor came, they were going to redress my wounds. You do go to the hotel with a drain tube hanging out of you, and it's about this big around, and it's like a little bulb, and it fills up with like blood and gunk. It's disgusting to look at, but it's very necessary. Okay, there's a nurse on staff there the whole time. The doctor came in, looked at my wounds, said everything went great, everything looked great. Went ahead, changed my wounds out. The next morning, they went ahead and did my leak test. Okay, so let me give you a heads up about the leak test, because no one gave me this news. They are going to bring you this little bottle. I would say it's smaller than this apple juice bottle, okay? It's probably about this big, from about here, okay? It's a water bottle. It's purple. Now, I use water drops like these, so I thought purple, oh, it's going to be grape flavored. Honey, you're in Mexico. Nothing is grape flavored. That was the most disgusting drink I've ever drank in my life. It was not grape flavored. It was not water flavored. It tasted like ass. It took me an hour and a half to get that purple yuck down. Now, it's very important you drink all of it, because they need that so that they can see your stomach to do your leak test. Once you drink that, they're going to pick you up in the van, take you to a different lab, and do your leak test. And the lab, they take you back. It's pretty much like an x-ray. It's nothing painful at all. They make you stand on this little step against like a backboard, kind of like I said, an x-ray machine. And the radiologist is going to hand you a styrofoam cup. And he's going to tell you to take a big gulp. Don't drink it all, because you're going to need another big gulp. That doesn't taste nowhere near as bad as the purple stuff does. It's still not pleasant. It's still not water. It's still not Sprite. Nothing good. But it's nowhere near as bad as the purple stuff. They take a picture after the first gulp. Then he tells you to take the second gulp, which should finish off your cup. And then he's going to take a second picture. And what this does is it just shows them if there's any leakage around your actual stomach, to make sure that, you know, everything's good, sealed, and tight. No one in my group had any leaks, so that was a good thing. Once you finish there, they take you back to the hotel. At this point, once you've passed your leak test, you're pretty much on your own, except for wound care changes and stuff like that, for your bandages, and any medication, okay? your pain medicine to not be excited and think you're getting morphine drips or Oxycontin, because you're not. They're going to give you a pill called Mavidol, which is pretty much Toradol. Okay. It worked great for me. Like I said, I had very minimal pain. And realistically, I could have taken a whole lot more pain meds than what I did. But I didn't need them, and I'm not one to take pills if I don't need them. So after that, I did some more shopping after my leak test. The internet at the hotel sucks, let me just tell you now. I had to go between two different Wi-Fi settings that the hotel provided with me. FaceTime was in and out. It was very unpleasant. I could not upload videos to YouTube at all. So that's why you'll notice the date of upload on my videos is like, there's three of them that were uploaded today. And that's why. So essentially, I did stay out, walked a lot, because it does help pass that gas out of you. That is the most painful part, is getting the gas out. Once that gas is gone, you feel amazing. And walking is the best way to do it. Gas X strips are a joke. Do not waste your money or your time going and trying to find them and buy them. So let me go back to this part now, okay? My incisions look great. They knew I was allergic to plastic medical tape. They did use paper tape on me, which I've never had a problem with before. And I didn't have a problem while I was in Tijuana. But leave it to me to get on a plane and come home and wake up the next morning with blisters and a rash all over my stomach. And I will show you my incisions. As you can see, the redness around my incisions there. Let me get my hands out of the way. And you can't really see my, ouch, my blisters real bad, but they're there. I have very sensitive skin, and stupid me decided that paper tape would be fine, since, you know, it's pretty much the only thing you have except plastic tape. Little did I know I was going to grow an allergy to the adhesive in paper tape. And so I did follow up with my primary physician today. It is a tape burn, and it's treatable. I am airing my wounds out sooner than I really should be because of this. But there's a product on the market that I can use. It's just going to take a little longer to get my stomach healed back up. It's called Tegaderms. Now, Tegaderms is made by NexCare. For any of you that do encounter something like this, it's made by NexCare. It's you can get it at your local drugstore. For me, the price at the drugstore is outrageous. You get eight like bandages for $11.50. Or you can order it in bulk through Sam's if you have a Sam's membership, and you get 100 of them for like $50. So I did the 100 for $50. It's still outrageous, I know, but since I'm allergic to plastic and paper tape, I have a feeling I might need these again. So that's what we're going with. It's just, you know, something that came up. It's nothing to do with Dr. Almanza. It's nothing to do with Mexico. It happens, and I was prepared for some sort of a complication. If this is the worst thing that happens, I'm okay with it. Now, back to the radiologist issue. The radiologist that did my original EKG and blood work, I did tell you kind of the situation that happened. It was not just me. It was pretty much everybody there. I got a call to this evening from Jared at Weight Loss Agent. And we had let him know about the situation the day we were coming home. He did call me this evening personally to let me know that doctor, I guess you would call him, has been put on suspension until he clears his act up and realizes that is inappropriate, not allowed. Weight Loss Agents is no longer allowing him to work on their patients as of right now, from what I'm understanding from Jared. And so that makes me feel a lot better. It was nothing, you know, he didn't take his penis out of his pants or anything like that. It was just, you know, a little too close for comfort. And, you know, because he doesn't speak very fluent English, it makes it very hard to say, you know, get the hell away from me. So that's why Weight Loss Agents is there. And they want to know if you've had a problem like that or, you know, a situation arises while you're there. The best thing you can do is call Weight Loss Agents, tell them what's going on. If you've got a Weight Loss Agent rep on site while you're there, tell them. Because if they find out, they're going to fix it. You know, they're going to make you as comfortable as possible. And, you know, when I started into the surgery, I read a lot of testimonials about how they're over at Jerusalem Hospital. Dr. Almanza has not been at Jerusalem since February. He is in an actual hospital with an actual ICU. The hospital is very nice. It's not in a strip mall. Well, it kind of is in a strip mall, but not like an American strip mall. There's, you know, other doctor's offices like underneath, but just like any normal U.S. hospital has. And I mean, it's very clean. It's a very, very clean situation. There's, you know, I would say that the hospital there is cleaner than half the hospitals in the States. You know, realistically, and I'm not going to get into this really big until later, the big difference, and a lot of doctors discourage you going to Mexico for surgery, is because of money. They want the money. The government wants your money. They get taxed on that surgery. They pay taxes on your surgery. They want your money here in the States. There was a guy there that I was talking to. He had his sleeve done the day after I did. He is Puerto Rican, and he was telling me that in the Dominican Republic, you can get the same surgery. It's still more expensive than in Mexico, but less expensive than in the States. It's about in the middle, kind of. But he said that down there, it's not clean. He would never recommend it. But he didn't realize exactly how expensive the surgery was here in the States. And when I told him, he was shocked. He thought, you know, that it would be the same amount. But he was a Mexican slaver, and he spoke very fluent English. But he also spoke very fluent Spanish, which was good for me. I used him to negotiate quite a bit, by the way. So I guess, you know, don't always believe what you read. I was very big into gastricsleeve.com. It's a forum. If you're thinking about the surgery, if you're having the surgery, if you're going to have the surgery anytime soon, or if you've had this surgery, join that group. There are tons of people with all sorts of questions, all sorts of answers. You know, if you're going through something, post it. I mean, people are there to answer your questions and to help you as much as they can. You know, will I recommend the surgery to anybody else? Hell yes. I would do it again in a heartbeat. And, you know, that's me being sober, not on anesthesia, me being home for a whole day after my flight. Yes, I'm tired, but I'm not miserable. Realistically, you know, other than my own body hating tape, Everything looks beautiful on me. My wounds are pretty. I really expect very minimal scarring from the surgery. I will probably have a bigger scar from my tummy tuck in a year than I will from my wounds. As for weight loss, I'm not weighing for at least a week because I am still full of fluids and gas and stuff like that. And it's too soon after surgery. You just don't do it. You'll make yourself miserable. I am going to wait a week. But I will continue to update. I will continue to post videos. I just want you guys to know that, if you have questions, I will answer them the best that I can. I'm not a pro at this. I'm not a doctor. I'm not a nurse. I'm just a normal 367-pound patient that's going through this process. And I want you to understand that you're not alone. A lot of the fears that you probably have, I've had. A lot of the symptoms you're going through or are going to go through, I've been there, except for pain. Don't ask me about pain because I had very little. What I have heard and understand is the skinnier you are for this surgery, you probably will have a little more pain. I'm sorry. And I'm not talking about like if you're 300 pounds and not 367. I'm talking about the people that are getting the sleeve done and they weigh like 190 pounds or 220 pounds. And their goal weight is only like 50 or 60 pounds. And I did meet a couple people like that, that were down there. They're having the sleeve done for blood pressure or cholesterol or something like that. I don't know. I didn't have my surgery at that weight. I'm sorry. I can recommend you somebody to talk to that was there with me when I had surgery. That is closer to your weight if you have questions. But I'm not gonna pretend that I do know what you're going through if I don't. I'll tell you what I do know, and what I do know is that Dr. Almanza, he speaks very little English. His hands are amazing. Your body starts like this and in a few months goes like this. And all your skin goes like this. And that's exactly how he's going to tell you, by the way. He speaks very little fluent English, but he does speak enough English that you can understand him. I will recommend Dr. Almanza to anybody that is looking for a way to lose your weight. And I will recommend the surgery to anyone who needs a recommendation. Okay. So I will post again as soon as I get my wounds healing or my stitches come out. I do get to eat baby food on Thursday. So I'm very excited. 2 more days and I can have baby food. But in the meantime, I'm on a sippy cup. By the way, do not take their suggestion of sippy cups lightly. You need this to drink water and any other fluid. Very important. It will feel like a ton of bricks. So until then, or until a couple days from now, I will let you guys go. And sorry, this was a 28-minute video with a lot of rambling. But it's everything I needed to say. So, y'all have a great night. Bye.